Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is BestInSlot with something perhaps a little bit unexpected. Tonight we're going to play Total War Warhammer 2, which we'll be calling Total Warhammer 2 because I'm not a crazy person. We're going to be starting a new campaign with the Lizardmen. For those who don't know, Lizardmen are, of course, lizard men. Basically, they've got lizards with swords, we've got sort of big stegodons, we've got carnosaurs, we've got lizards on chairs who go ooga booga booga and cast a little bit of magic, the slam. We're going to start a new campaign with those guys as part of our mission to play every single dinosaur game ever invented. I couldn't skip Total Warhammer 2, and a lot of you guys have been recommending it in the comments. Now, I should say I've played quite a lot of this game and the first game. The first game in particular, I've got like 200 hours or so in, but I'm not a very good player. So hopefully today we're going to focus a little bit more on the battling and the tactics and stuff, and at least do moderately okay. So let's go into campaigns. We'll start a new campaign. We're going to do Eye of the Vortex, which is the default Total Warhammer 2 campaign. There is a new one, the Mortal Empires, which includes all the different races, but considering I don't know what the hell I'm doing, it's probably better to start with Vortex again. Shut up, Tyrion. So each of the four default factions currently gets two legendary lords, and that chooses your starting position, faction bonuses, and stuff like that. So this is the High Elf one. And they've all got initial challenge levels. Now, when the Tomb Kings come out in January, they're actually going to get four. I'm very excited about the Tomb Kings. But for the Lizardmen, we have Lord Mazdamundi, who is a Hexwattle faction. And as you can see, he is my Wooga Booga Booga. He's a slan. I've got a fun story about the slan, which we'll talk about in a second. And we also have Kroq'gar, who is the Last Defenders faction. He's much more of a melee, get-in-your-face kind of fighter. One of the strongest melee fighters in the entire game. As far as I'm aware, the only two who really compete with him are Queek and Malekith. And I believe Kroq'gar stands up reasonably well to both of them. Malekith's kind of a badass, though. Here's a Hydra. I want a Hydra. Anyways, today we're going to play as Kroq'gar. And starting units, we have a Feral Stegodon, and we have some Kroxigors, who are big, monstrous infantry. A lot of this stuff I don't pay much attention to in the past. Today we're going to try to a little bit more, you know, so I can actually be a moderately okay player. So let's start a new campaign. There's going to be an introductory video. Enjoy that, and we'll get started.
Since the days of creation, the reptiles have dominated the jungle continent of Lustria. The ignorant call the creatures lizardmen. The wise know them as defenders of the world. In ages past, the old ones had a plan. But then the stellar gates collapsed, the old ones fled, and demons flooded the mortal plane. Led by the slan, the lizard men fought the demons that surged across Lustria. Yet, it was the elves that created the great vortex. A swirling maelstrom that siphoned the world of chaos, withering demon kind. The world was saved, but the vortex endures only because it is bolstered by the power of the slan via the great warding. If the warding should fail, the demons will return.
The forked tongue of Sotex hangs low in the sky. The slan have felt it. Now I see it brighter, clearer. It's his. Disturbs the winds of magic. Look, Targrax, the sacred plaques. One prophecy shines above all others. Vortex
So, that little dude over there, the Slan. Fun story about that. I used to play the Warhammer tabletop game. I was merely more of a painter and collector, but I painted and collected Lizardmen. They were my army. This is, you know, a decade ago at least, since I did it. But I loved the Lizardmen because they were dinosaurs. Obviously, I was always going to collect Lizardmen. This dude's going to talk about stuff I don't care about. And I remember going to a battle day at Games Workshop to learn, you know, a beginner battle day, one where you learn how to fight. And we had to bring a 1,500 point army. It's actually changed how Warhammer works now, but basically each unit or squad or whatever had a number of points assigned to it. And you had to fit your point totals of your army within a certain point limit, typically 1,500 or so for new players at the very least, and more like 3,000 to 4,000 more advanced players. So we had a 1,500 point limit, but I really wanted to play with my Slan Mage Priest, who had painted and like taken such good care of, like 100 hours painting this guy. He's a big, heavy metal model, you know, it took a lot of effort to paint. So I took him, and they basically told me, you know, don't do this because it's a solo Slan Mage. He took up like every single point I had. It was like 1450 points or something. I couldn't fit any other unit in my army. He took up every single unit in my army, basically. So we got a first mission to take a settlement beginning to the following faction, Clan Mordekaiser, which is the Skaven. That's going to get us some treasury points, some gold, basically. And we also have to ensure that one of the following buildings has been constructed, one of these. Okay. So there's a few things we'll do to start. Anyway, I'm going to finish the story very quickly. I told me not to do it, and I decided, you know what, I love this guy so much, I'm going to play with my Slan Mage. Anyway, took him in solo, got absolutely crushed, and then at the end of the day, I was standing next to my friend who I went to the Games Workshop with as this beginner day, and the guy running the thing turned to my friend, very explicitly, not to me, and said, hey, do you want to come for the intermediate day? You know, intermediate battle day, you know, play against better players, we'll get better armies and stuff like that. And then just walked away, so I stared at him like, I was staring at him thinking, come on. And he's like, nope, you're an idiot. You only wanted to play with your Slan Mage. Get out of my shop. Basically how it felt. And that is my traumatic childhood experience. So, here we go. Now, there's something I do at the start of every campaign. I've played the start of this campaign about 100 times. I'm not even joking. It's something I like to do every time. So you can see over here on the right-hand side, we've got, oh, hello, the remnants of Batman. So, I've never seen that before. Interesting. We have something here called the Cursed Jungle. Now, this is completely on its own. It's a minor settlement. There's no entrance point here or here other than by the sea. If we click the Cursed Jungle, you can see that it forms a... I can't remember what this is called when it's a... It's a province. And it's got three settlements in it. The Temple of Skulls, which is my province capital that I already own. This is my main base. Serpent Coast and Cursed Jungle. If you own all three, they get stronger. You can put in a province effect, so like a general commandment to boost certain effects. And the strength of that effect is determined by your geomantic web, which is something we'll talk about a little bit later. The problem is, you've got this army of Kroq'gar right here, right? There he is, Kroq'gar, being a badass. You want to take him to the left and take out the Skaven here, and then you want to take out the Serpent Coast. By the time you do that and then go all the way back to the Cursed Jungle to get that one so you can complete the area, the guys on the west tend to take back the Serpent Coast or take it for themselves, and they get stronger. So what I like to do, and this could be a terrible, terrible idea, but what I do like to do, recruit a lord nice and early and start sending them over to the east to take the Cursed Jungle. Now, a lord hurts your gold economy quite badly, and you don't really need two of them at the start. What a lord does is they lead an army, basically. So what I do is I send him to the Cursed Jungle, take the Cursed Jungle, and then kill him. It sounds mean, but I think it's the right way to do it. That's kind of just how I've started to do it anyway. We've also got a little hero here, Radok, or Skink Priest. And he's going to go ahead and join my main army, I think, for now. Skink Priests, or heroes in general, what they do is they go around the world and they cleanse corruption from chaos or the vampires. They block enemy heroes, they block ambushes, they scout out for you generally. But for now, we'll just have him as part of the army, gaining a little bit of experience. So, Kroq'gar. Gonna head to the west and attack. What's this guy called? Murder Scratchuska. Apologies. Whew. Who ran away like a bloody coward, eh? Get him. It's a little bit out of range, which is weird because I tried this video about half an hour ago, and he was not out of range. He let me kill him. Oh well, we're going to have to wait a turn. I'll get you next turn, Sunny Jim. The problem is if he gets too close to the Serpent Coast, yeah. I think there's already a Skaven army in the Serpent Coast, so this battle may have just got a little bit tougher. We should still be okay. I'm gonna give it a go anyway. Yeah, we're gonna... You can see they've got a settlement garrison here, the Sean Scourge. We have a few clan rats, Skaven slaves. They're nothing particularly scary, it's just a little bit more to handle than there was going to be, basically. Skaven are really good. What they do is they hide in settlements, so you can't really see that army beforehand. You don't even know they're there. All the time, you'll come across a ruined settlement, you'll go in, and you'll get smashed. But, usually I would auto-resolve this, but I want to do, like, just one big fight, at least in this video, so we're gonna go ahead and do that. Now, typically, you want to fight all your battles, because although the AI is pretty good, an auto-resolve, if you've got a stronger army, tends to work. If you want to reduce your casualties and stuff like that, it's better to fight for yourself. The problem with that is, I'm terrible at the fighting portion of this game. In terms of overall tactics and managing the map, I think I'm okay. In terms of actually in battle, I so rarely do it that I am fairly awful. So, this is my practice. Basically, we're going to do our big fight, and it's all going to be fine. You can see we're in Skaven world, though. Bloody Nora. Zoom in over here. Look at this Skaven monstrosity going on here. Let's just knock out that for a second. I know. So we've got something called the Winds of Magic. And this is what our characters use to cast spells. And because we've got a spellcaster here in our little skink priest, there he is, Ratok. Looking lovely, Ratok. We can gamble, so basically try to get more Winds of Magic. But I think 20 is fine, so we're just going to start our deployment. First things first, let's take a look at the battlefield itself. We can't actually see their units, because they were holed up and hiding. They're here somewhere. I've got to just assume that if I just march forward, I'll find the sneaky rats and other guns. They're definitely around. Oh my god. It's terrifying in here. So, let's take a look at the units we actually have to offer. First things, let's just move everyone back and we'll sort of rebuild this. So we've got our frontline units, which is our Kroq'gars. These are monstrous infantry. We're going to get those guys right up front. Because they are, in a word, awesome. Look at him. He's a giant crocodile dinosaur man with a hammer. I love how they've varied up the weaponry as well. You see some guys have got these sort of pickaxe hammer things, these spiky ball things, spades. You never know, folks. You never know what you're going to find. So we've got three different types of weaponry. Our other sort of frontline units are the Saurus Warriors. These are always your... These tend to be the units that... I'm wondering if they should be more frontline and Kroq'gars because you kind of attack from the side. I don't really know, guys. I've got to be honest, I don't know. So I'm kind of just going to make this up as I go along. I'm going to stick our Saurus at the front. We're going to put our Kroq'gars to the side a little bit. Try to get them to come in from the flanks and smash some people up a little bit. I don't really have any cavalry at this point in time, so... over here we have... Oh, I should show you guys the Saurus Warriors quickly. Hey, well, I'll make the army first. Grab our skinks. These are our javelin skinks, so these are ranged dudes. I'm going to just stick them behind Saurus. Got our two heroes. They can just stand in the middle. That's fine. And over here, we have the Stegodon, which is awesome. He can go there. I don't know. Whatever. Let's have a quick little look at our units. So, our front line are there. Saurus warriors. Little hatchets, little swords. These are, like I said, if you've ever built Lizardmen, you inevitably had quite a few Saurus warriors. These are the meat of your army, basically. And they're very cool. There's Kroq'gar, who's just incredibly awesome. There's really no other word for it. They're glowing, he's got hand of Midas on for some reason. He's got an awesome javelin spear thing, golden armor, baller. There's our skinks, little lizardy dudes. Amazing. And finally, over here on the flank, the Stegodon. Which is, I don't know. It's kind of like an Ankylosaurus, Triceratops, Stegosaurus hybrid, right? It's a baller, either way, that's what we're going for. It's a baller. I really don't know where that guy should be. Maybe he should just be in the middle. Leading the charge. Let's go for it. We'll see what happens. What's the worst that could happen? Oh, and there they are. Now, I want to see what they're doing before I do anything else. There's quite a big army here. Are they moving forward at all? You're a spooky son of a gun, aren't you? So this is actually a good time to move forward, because they've got all that missile infantry in the front lines, which doesn't make sense to me. And there's their leader right there, Murta Scratchware. Oh, they've got two, don't they? Hello. Alright, simmer down, lads. Simmer down. Like I said, I'm not going to pretend I really know what I'm doing. I'm just going to move forward slowly. The Stegodon appears to move at a faster rate than everyone else. I want to make sure he doesn't go alone. You need to keep safe, buddy, okay? We all care about you a lot. I'll have a quick little look. What can this dude do? Augment. So the only spell my Skink Mage has right now is the ability to boost up my allies, which, hey, when we get in there, it's going to be quite useful. I'm just going to go in, basically. My skinks are kind of at the front. Not really what I was looking for. Right, time to charge. Go. Okay. Let's go to war. Stegodon charges in. Bam. Covered in blood already. Took no time at all. This thing is a monster. It will take a beating from everyone and emerge absolutely okay. Right, so I'm going to buff my Kroq'gars up now. My javelin guys, are they firing or what are you guys doing? There we go. Meow! Beautiful stuff. Kroq'gar is charging in there, smashing brains. Right, I want to pause it, have a little look, show you guys what is. Look at this dude. Can't see him because his friend's blocking. He's just about to bring that down on the head of this Skaven right here. Let's watch. I want to see it happen. I really want to see it. Can I see it happen? No, there's no slow motion. There is. We are. Oh, I missed. That's the stuff. We're gonna let the fight play out just for a few. Like, this is why I'm not good at this game, because I don't care so much about the tactics as much as I do seeing my lizardmen bash people's heads in, you know? Hopefully you can blame. Oh no, I'm a Kroq'gar. This dude's just on all fours, jumping away. Oh, he died. Did he die? Oh, he's got Skaven in his mouth. Oh my god, that was a crocodile move. That's what he's doing. He's doing like... He's actually just swallowed the Skaven. That is incredible. Oh my god. I've never seen that before. You are my favorite. He did the spin, you know, like crocodiles when they get hold of an enemy and they spin around with them in their mouths. That's awesome. All right. You are like my main fighter and you aren't doing anything. Get in there. What's going on over here? All right. You're getting fired on by that. You can turn around. Alright, you, my friend, are kind of just surrounded by your own army, which isn't good for you. You need to get in there a little bit. Charge into their infantry. Kroq'gars have pretty much annihilated everyone. We're just going to sort of pushing them forward now. The only unit they've got left is over here. I'm going to get both my javelins on these to take care of them. Let's get time going again. You see they're already... Go, Stegodon, go! Bash! Right, this is... No, I have to. I wish the sound stayed in slow motion, but... How can you not absolutely adore that? It's incredible! He just tore through their entire flank. Look, they're all swarming on him, but he's not going to care, I promise you. Little, silly, rash people. There's quite a lot of them. Go, Stegodon, go. Bam! Okay. What's going on elsewhere? Everyone stop moving forward, please. All right, you guys are over there. You need to go over there. Maybe buff someone else up. Yeah. Buff my Stegodon. All right, so that's their leader. I'm actually going to pull my leader back onto theirs. Kroq'gar, as far as I know, is... I can't remember if I said this before. But basically, between him and one of the Skaven and one of the Dark Elves is pretty much the strongest melee fighter in the entire game. So you really want to get him into combat, you know? I'm going to get my Saurus Warriors onto those infantry there. They're retreating a lot, which is a problem. I don't really have the ammunition reserves to handle long-range engagements. Bish, bash, bosh. They're just firing on my Saurus warriors. It's actually becoming a problem. I'm gonna send my Stegodon in. You! Go do something! Go get the scavenging slaves. These guys are just fighting with their leader. I'm not sure it's gonna go well. But my leader's gonna take on all of their army, hopefully. Oh, he just absolutely decapitated that Skaven. Later on, this guy's going to get a big Carnosaur mount and he just becomes... Oh! He just becomes an absolute god. There's really no other word for it. He becomes a god. They are retreating a lot, but it's actually kind of a pain in the ass. How are my Kroq'gar doing? They're okay. Getting attacked from the west. Where's my Stegodon at? Oh, it's over there. It's kind of charged those guys away. Okay. They're cowards, is what they are. They do a lot of retreating, and it's annoying. Kroq'gar, charge them down! Bish, bash, bosh! That was looking a little uneven to me, but the Saurus Warriors just got a big, big buff. Everyone's just a little bit tired. I'm working my guys pretty hard. Oh, I have more units. Did I just forget like half my army? What's going on over here? Oh, it's my Skaven from before. I completely forgot about this. I've just killed. My Skaven have been nowhere near the fight. They've been killing their Skaven unit. Completely alone. That was my bad, really. Oopsie daisy. What's going on over here? You guys need a rest. I'm going to let you just chill at the... My Saurus Warriors are kind of doing their own thing now. They're very tired. This is one of the problems I have. My guys get tired a lot and it's my fault. You should not be fighting on your own like this. I need to get you out of there. Oh, I won anyway. It was messy to say the least. I'm going to end the battle now. I don't want my guys to take any more hits, basically. You can see what I mean. I'm not particularly... That should be a very, very easy fight. And I'm not particularly adept at fighting, but I need the practice more than anything else, you know. I don't do many fights, so... I need to spend a bit more time researching how each unit works and stuff like that. But hey, more than anything, I really enjoy seeing the awesome creatures. So what do we want to do?
Take what you want.
Yeah. There we go. We took the building, wiped out their army, wiped out part of that faction, and we've finally, once we take the jungle over here, which we'll do in one more turn, we'll own the entire province. So let's check our missions and quests. Still need to make one of those buildings, and we still need to take control of a province. That's going to get us 2,000 gold and 7 ancient plaques. Now what the plaques do, and they're quite important to this specific campaign, is they work towards these rituals of prognostication. Well, that's the first one anyway. And basically by getting to the end of that, I don't really know what happens. It basically stops chaos or you win or... I don't really know how it works, but if we zoom out in the middle over here, there's a big swirly thing. Whom, the vortex. And we're basically fighting for control of this vortex. And these rituals is how we do it. So we want to, any sites that have these little... ritual stone things. We want to get those as quickly as possible. So the plan is going to be to take the Golden Tower. Now that is owned by Lizardmen, but if I take it and have a decent sized army, I'll kill them enough that they'll kind of beg for forgiveness, basically. That tends to be the tactic for those. These guys were replenishing, so we're going to let them regenerate a little bit, but I need to build this army up a little bit more as well. So we're going to get some Saurus Spears guys, because I feel a little limited in terms of my... ranged, and we'll get some more dudes as well. And now we can level up a little bit. So, Kroq'gar. Actually, he gets a cold one, which is like a raptor-esque mount, and then he gets Grimlock, which is a giant ageless Carnosaur, and it's absolutely awesome. But we're going to get Root Marcher for now. I feel this is one of the best ones to pick up nice and early. It just lets him move much further on the map. Enemies have a tendency, if you have a stronger army, to kind of flee and back away from you, so I like to be able to catch up to them relatively quickly. Buildings. We need to repair the Serpent Coast. Do I want this? No, I don't think so. Well, we'll keep it for now. It's fine. So we'll repair both of those. And we're good. So the plan's going to be to build up the army here, take the Golden Tower, come back down to the Serpent Coast. Oh. You can attack me? No. I want to take Teotihuacan and this whole sort of western ridge. This whole area is quite defensible. Yeah, I'll do it, don't worry. Search a ruined settlement that's going to get us more plaques and some more treasury. Give me a bloody minute. They also want us to take the Golden Tower, which we will do. But we want to do this one, and there's also Temple Avenue of Gold, which is sort of around here somewhere. And then there's, you can kind of take this whole coastline, and then as long as you've got an army sit there and here, you kind of, you own the southern coast of this area. There's some units down here, blah, 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 but generally speaking, you're pretty safe until later on in the game when chaos starts to get involved. And chaos don't get involved until these rituals start to happen. So, technology. We can only get one. Let's grab that. That gives us some melee defense for our Saurus units. Eventually, we'll get some really cool stuff, but way down the line. Each sort of different faction has different ways of researching. You kind of have to, with the Lizardmen, you kind of follow along with one of these, and then you have to get a big one to unlock these middle ones. Buildings! What do I need? We're going to upgrade this. That gives us more growth. Growth lets us upgrade our buildings faster. Basically, this is our main thing. We want to get this level 5. That's going to unlock new buildings, unlock stronger units, stuff like that. And to do that, you need a growth surplus. So you see, we need 2 population surplus for that. We have 1 population surplus at the moment, and 5 turns until we get another surplus point. We are going to spend upgrading this one, however, which will eat our surplus. And I think that's it. I really just want this army to... My skink cohort, I'm just gonna upgrade it a little bit further. What did I just unlock? Oh right, I got spear guys as well. Okay, I'm kind of spending all my cash on this at the moment, which seems like a bad idea, but it's fine. We are about to take the cursed jungle. So we can colonize, which I can't do because I have no money because I'm stupid, but what we want to do the first time anyway is treasure hunt. And this is going to give us like a random event, and we have to decide what we want to do. One good turn, Ratul. As you search through the remains of a collapsed colonnade, cries for help echo through the rubble. People are trapped beneath. Although their welfare is of little interest, I do speak English, I promise, they may be of some use. So you order that the area be cleared and the survivors freed, leave them to die beneath the fallen masonry, or perhaps pursue another course of action. So, we can leave them to their fate, attempt blackmail, ignore them, look elsewhere, or try to help. I feel like I'm a nice dude. I'm going to try to help. It may backfire. It looks like we got a hero for it. Hibiscus, the Saurus Scar veteran. I'm watching you, Goros Deathmaker, Sonny Jim. Don't you worry about it. I've got my eye on you, buddy boy. Yeah, hero recruited at Temple of Skulls, Saurus Scar veteran. Awesome. So he's going to sit there for a couple turns, just until we've got 2,500, and that's going to let us take the cursed jungle. Where is he? Hibiscus. Cool. He's going to go join the main army. Or train the main army or something. Can I only have one hero per main army? What's this? Oh, okay. So he's going to go sit with my main army. Not part of the army, as far as I can tell, but he's just going to sit with them and train them up and give them XP every turn. What heroes do is either join your army as a unit, like my little skink priest has, or they do actions around the map, like blocking enemy armies, setting up, blocking ambushes, assassinating heroes, or seemingly giving XP to your armies. So, what's this? Oh, Ratul, you need to sit there, buddy, I'm afraid. Is it space to right turn? Kind of forgotten. Yeah, there we go. And we can level up our lovely, let's buff that spell. We've used that. We're going to use that quite a lot. We're going to end it there, folks. Little fun with the Lizardmen, basically. I know people weren't maybe expecting this, but I've wanted to do this for a while. People have been asking for it. It's basically a dinosaur game. It's a lot of fun. If you haven't played Total War before and you're a little nervous about it, you know, my very first Total War game was the first version of this game was Total War Warhammer 1. And eventually you get used to it, you get into it, and it's a lot of fun. Even if you enjoy the battling, which isn't my main thing, I tend to like this sort of overarching strategy rather than the actual tactical battles, despite how pretty they look. Then, you know, you can definitely play through pretty much the entire game like that. You can auto-resolve every battle except specific ones, which are like unique missions for your heroes. Right, I'm gonna go. If you did like this video, please leave a like down below. Leave a comment if you played the game before. Did you play Lizardmen? Basically, are you excited for the Tomb Kings? Thanks for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. I shall see you lovely folks in the next episode. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. Hey guys, if you enjoyed this video, please consider smashing that like button down below. It really helps me out. And also hitting the subscribe button if you want to be kept up to date with brand new videos about dinosaurs, animals, aliens, and everything else we do here on the Best in Slot channel. All of you who have subscribed so far, that's awesome. Make sure you hit that little bell icon. I'll highlight now. Otherwise, you may actually miss out on the content anyway because YouTube is silly. Thank you guys so much. Much love.